Hi, my name is Lacey Comanda. I am a certified Revelation Wellness instructor where we combine our faith with our fitness. It's a total body experience of worshiping God with all our heart, mind, soul, and strength. So as we focus on His Word and move our bodies, just the walls of our heart come down so we can hear what He's saying maybe a little better. So today we have a 20, 10, 15 workout. We're going to do three different rounds. It's going to be 20 reps of one exercise, 10 of another, and 15 of core. And so, yeah, we'll just follow along. But today we are in John chapter 8, verse 12. It says, when Jesus spoke again to the people, he said, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. And we're just going to hold on to that verse because sometimes when we're walking through life, it kind of feels like we are walking in darkness. But when we're following Jesus, we can trust that he's leading us into his light and he's showing us his good paths that he has for us. While it may feel like darkness to us, it is not darkness to him. And the fact that Jesus never leads us to a path of destruction, that's never his course for us. He will let us go through trials, through difficulties, but he never leads us down those roads to destroy us, but rather to bring us more into his light, to lead us in his light. And we can trust that he is the light of the world, and what we can't see, he sees it clearly. He sees not only the bigger picture, he sees the whole picture. So all we get to do, all we have to do, which is really hard sometimes, is just to trust one step at a time. Even though we can't see the way, he sees the way, and he knows what he's doing, and we can trust him. We can just press into him, and we can just say, you know what, this is hard. This feels like darkness, but I know that you are the light of the world, and you lead me in your light, and so I'm going to trust. I'm going to trust that next step, and I know that you know the way, and so I'm just going to follow you. So that's what we're going to move in today. If you have not warmed up, go ahead and push pause. Go for a walk around your neighborhood or do some jumping jacks, march in place, just kind of get that blood flowing, kind of stretch out. As you're moving, just get a little loose. Otherwise, if you're ready, we will go ahead and start. You will need a mat if you're on a hard floor or be on your carpet or a rug. And then a set of weights. If you don't have weights, you can use soup cans. I've used landscaping bricks before. And any of that would work. So go ahead and find your space to move. And let's move in the fact that Jesus is the light of the world. He'll never lead us into darkness, but he'll lead us along his path of life. So let's trust in that. Whether we feel like it or not, we're going to trust and we're going to move and just enjoy him. So, all right. So our first move that we're going to do are air squats. So with your feet about hip-width apart, you squat down and you stand up as quick as you can. If you want more, you can do pencil squats. So you're going to do 20, all right? All right, let's get our music going. I got my assistant here with me, Kate, my daughter, said press play. All right. So whenever you're ready, at your own pace, if you want to keep up with me, great. If you don't, that's fine. If you go faster than me, you just do you. All right, 20 air squats. Turn the corners of your mouth up. There's 10 for me. Good job. Four, three, two, one. All right, 10 push-up, open up. So come onto my mat. If you need to fold up your mat on your knees or add more padding, you can be on your knees or you can be on your toes. You're going to push up, open it up to one side. Push up, open up the other side. That's two. There's five, halfway. Two more, you got it. Tuck that core in. Nice work. All right, 15. You're gonna find that flat back. Your feet Join in when you're ready. Back to those squats.
There's 10.
14, 15. Good job. Good job. All right, let's go do it again. We'll get a break here in a second. 20 mountain climbers. Ready, set, begin. 2, 3, 4, 9, 10. 15, 18, 19, 20. Good job. Oh, can you smile? Can you smile? Come on your back. Still engage that core. Weights overhead, 10 triceps. Go. 2, 3, 4, 6, 9, 10. Good job. All right, 15 bicycles. You can adjust the angle of your feet. 4, 5. Figure out what works best for you. 9, 12, 13, 14, 15. Woo, how's that core feel? Good work. Good work. Slowly sit on up. Sit on up. 2 rounds are done. Good work. 2 rounds are done. Just got one more round. So as we think about Jesus being the light of the world, and he's leading us in his paths, he's leading us in his light, how have you seen that play out in your life? Can you look back in certain seasons of your life and realize, oh, I didn't understand it at the time, but now I can see, God, more clearly what you are doing, right? So maybe you're in the midst of a dark time or just uncertainty. It's okay, you don't have to know all the details. Trust me, I'm one that wants all the details. I love to plan. But when we can trust him, knowing that he's carrying out all the details and all the paths for his good plans, for our own good, we can walk in faith, and maybe later we can look back and we can say, oh, I see what you did. I see how you're preparing us. So good. So good to follow him. And we may not see completely on this side of heaven, but when we get to heaven, everything's going to make perfect sense. All right, 20 lunges. So it's 20 with each lunge that you do. You can weight these if you want. If you don't want to weight them, that's okay. So standing nice and tall, shoulders back and down, belly button tucked toward your spine. Step forward, bend down. That's one. Here's 2, 4, 5. About a 90 degree bend in your knees. Here's 11. Good job. If you need to set your weights down, go ahead. Here's 15. Use that core. 20. All right, 10 star jumps. Ready? So it's like a jumping jack, but you're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4. Here's less impact. 7, 8, 9, 10. Good job. All right, 15. Pike. Hold the pike. Knee in. 1. There's 2. Tailbone high. 3, 4. Nine. Come on. Two more. 14. Last one. 15. Good job. Good job. Woo, slowly come on up. When you're ready. 20 lunges. Last round. Last round. Chest lifted. You're going faster than me. Great. You're going slower. Keep going. Halfway. 10 more. There's 15. Last one, each leg. Nice job. Woo, set those down. All right. You're either here, star jumps, or you're here. Can you smile? 8, 9, 10. Good. Use your weight to begin relieve pressure on your wrists. Pike, knee in. Hold the pike. Bring your knee in. Tailbone down. Tailbone high. Other knee. Shoulder blades on your back. There's 6. Feel the sweat roll. Oh yeah. Halfway. Come on. Here's 10.
Chin to your neck.
slowly come on up. Take one arm, cross it in front, stretch out this arm. Take your arm up and behind. Use your head to press against that arm. Switch arms, take the other one across. Jesus is the light of the world. Whoever follows him will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. Doesn't mean it's easy. Doesn't mean that we see every step that we take. Take it up and behind. But it does mean we can trust him to lead us. Good. With your legs, crisscross them as far as you can. If you can stack your knees, great. Just make sure your hips are seated down on the mat. Inhale, sit nice and tall. Exhale as you fold forward. And slowly bring your hands out in front. Just bow your head. With the other one on top. Kind of wiggle into it. Sink those hips down. Sit up nice and tall. Exhale as you fold forward. Just think of the adventure he has us on. Do we really want to follow our own ways? Or do we want to follow him? For when we're smack dab in the middle of his will, is exactly where we need to be. And there's no greater life, no higher joy, or greater purpose than to be right where he has us, in his will, trusting fully. But hear me, I know it's not easy. Slowly sit on up. Take one ear to your shoulder and really slowly roll your neck down to the middle. Pause here before you roll to the other side. Then roll it back down to the center. Stay in the center. Just look straight up. Or sit on your bottom. Take one arm out to the side, the other one up and over, keeping that shoulder on your back. Look up under the top bicep. Inhale to the top, go to the other side. Your forehead.
calm down your neck. Release any tension that's built up.
Or any other position you want to finish out our time here. John 8. This is Jesus talking. When he's talking, we can listen. We better listen. Jesus says, "I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life." A little later in John, Jesus says, "You see in part, but I see in full." And if he is the God of all the universe, don't you think we can trust him with our next step? He can choose us before the creation of the world and have a perfect, good plan for us. It's not that our lives are perfect. It's not that we're perfect. But he can pick us before the beginning of the world and know exactly when he's going to place us on the earth. Don't you think we can trust him? We can trust him with the path that he has us on. Are there sins maybe we need to confess and get back in light with him? Yes. Examine our heart every day. But Jesus will never lead us into destruction. And when we can't see, we can't understand, and what feels like we're being destroyed, we're actually growing in his grace and in his truth. For he's working out that sin out of us. And he's bringing us into his light, giving us the light of life. It's humbling. It's comforting. It may be scary at the time. There's no better path that we can be on than to follow him fully, faithfully. Will we fall off side to side? Yeah. Yep. But his Holy Spirit inside of us, living in us, brings us back ever so faithfully and so gently. God not only sees the bigger picture, he sees the whole picture. How kind of him to let us be a part of his work here on the earth. So let's trust. I want to just declare this right along with you, because I need this. I need to just sink it down deep in my heart that he is the light of the world. He'll never lead me into destruction, but into his path of life. He gives me the light of life, which is closer to who he wants me to be. So whatever that looks like, any dying to myself that I need to do, to therefore then live fully, more fully in his spirit, then I say, come. Have your way in me. So Jesus, we just come to you with open hands and open hearts, Lord. We give you all the burdens and the concerns on our heart. None of it scares you. You know what's in there better than we know ourselves. We thank you that we can trust you. You are the light of the world. We just say that again. You are the light of the world. And when we walk with you, we never walk in darkness, but we walk in your path of light, and you give us the light of life. So God, though our next steps may seem shaky and unsure, we can trust that you are not unsure. You are constant. You are steady. You are our rock. You are our light. And you're drawing us in more and more closer to your heart. So we trust you. I say, I trust you, Lord, with the unknown, with the future, Forgive me for thinking I had my life all planned out, that nothing would ever change. Forgive me for not being open, obedient to your Spirit's leading. Forgive me for making my life an idol. God, may we worship you and you alone as you desire. You're so good. It's so, so good. So fun. Yes, scary at times, but so good to walk in your light. I praise you, Holy Spirit, that you live in us. You comfort us. You guide us. You teach us and correct us. So have your way in us. God, we open our hands. We open our hearts to you. We can trust you, for you are God above all. We take that next step with you. Thank you for your patience with us and your grace and your mercy. Help us not run ahead, not fall behind. And we praise you in advance for what you're doing in each of our lives. May it all be for your glory and yours alone. Thank you for your love. It's in Jesus' all-powerful and perfect and wonderful name that we pray. Amen.